You know, I mean, it's, really.
It's funny you bring that shit up too, because I can't wait for tomorrow when we talk about this shit. But Tony Khan.
Back at it again?
It's been
24 hours, dude. So I don't know. I don't know what did he do something on social media again? What happened with him?
He is going to give us a month's worth of content in one night.
Fuck. Why? What is he doing? Is he doing a shoot interview, brother? Is he sitting down after his 2 years of wrestling experience? He's ready to tell all. Is that what's going to happen?
I love that you can just read my feels. Tony Khan is going to give an in-depth talk about how AEW has revolutionized professional wrestling.
Yes. I love it. I fucking love it. You know what I think is the best about that entire concept? Is that, like, when you do a shoot interview, right, for the most part, when you do those, you know, at least back in the day when it was the 2-3 hour long ones, it was a lot of questioning about, you know, what were some of the things that you did? Do you have regrets? Do you have anything that you made mistakes about? And a lot of it wasn't really like self-aggrandizing. Oh, yeah. A lot of the old shoot interviews, a lot of it was kind of like, you know, airing of grievances mixed with
stories. You know, and yeah. It was a lot more surreal. It was more about explaining the life.
Yes.
What is the life like being a wrestler? And I think that's what people really fed it. That's what I fed into. We talked about this before, because even the Ric Flair shit, like, not only talks about is drinking and drugging and everything else like that, but it's like me and you even said, dude, there's so many stories that he has. There's so much more importance that this guy has, you know?
Yeah. Well, that's, you know what? I think that it's very telling of the fact that a lot of people aren't going back. And now this is when we're officially these like old motherfuckers. Cause like we're saying, you didn't even watch the Crash Holly shoot interview. You call yourself a wrestling historian. You don't fucking know. But like, you have to think there's no thirst to go back and listen to this shit. And honest to God, it's called torrents. It's all fucking free. It's still there for you. It's not like the wrestling torrents went away.
That's why I buy books, man. I just read the books, even though a lot of the books are ghost written and stuff like that. I think when you put something down on paper and in theory, on digital paper, I think there's a lot more weight behind it. I think I would take a book over a shoot interview any day.
Oh, see, I'm way more of an auditory person.
But I think that when you put it on paper and you have to see what you wrote, I think there's more to it than that.
See, I think you give yourself more room for bullshitting on paper.
Really? I think it's the other way around. You don't think that there's more responsibility for writing than there is?
No, but I think you have a better chance of somebody going writing something and then looking back and going, No. And fixing it to kind of shape something. Did you see what I'm saying? Like, it's way, way fucking easier for a person. Dude, just even with a computer, instead of like when you have somebody sit down and write something, because you sit down and write something and you're not crazy about it. You're like, I got to erase this whole fucking thing. Like, even that like 1 second of somebody thinking, I guess I gotta fuck it. Like that'll change the entire thing, as opposed to somebody typing something out and they go, not crazy about that, boop, and fill it back in 3 seconds. Do you know what I'm saying?